I don't think in 20 years of doing this that I have done one thing that takes sick people and makes them well people nearly as incredibly as this does. You can dispute the ickiness of this, but I don't think anybody can dispute anymore the efficacy of this. The science is clear. It's like a miracle.
Ryan Snider was a healthy 25-year-old when he developed a mysterious, debilitating condition.
I was being treated for what I now know as chronic pelvic pain. I was seeing urologists for it that were trying to diagnose it, and they thought it was other conditions such as an STD or a UTI, and so they were just prescribing me antibiotic after antibiotic. And I didn't know at the time that how devastating those are on your body. And so what the antibiotics did is kill all of the healthy bacteria, if you will. Every morning I was waking up vomiting before work, and I would still go to work and just feel terrible all day. It basically made my immune system similar to that of somebody who's inflicted with HIV or AIDS or cancer. It was from a stool sample that I finally found out that I had C. diff.
Clostridium difficile, or C. diff, is a bacterium that lives in the colon and can cause a number of severe symptoms, such as diarrhea, fever, weight loss, nausea, and pain. It affects about 500,000 patients a year, and it kills an estimated 15 to 30,000 people annually.
You know, normally I'm 175 pounds, I weigh about 155 right now.
Jeez.
So I've lost a ton of weight in the last year.
Most people with C. diff, which is what Ryan has, the dominant symptom is diarrhea. It's really horrible, horrible diarrhea. They're tired, they lose weight, they're fatigued, they have a bellyache. It can be life-threatening. People can die of this.
None of the medications help with my symptoms.
Do you take anything else?
I am on Prozac now. I'm seeing a therapist because it's just been really draining having this disease for so long. My appetite's not good. I'm feeling nauseous all the time. You know, I'm having trouble sleeping. I'm anxious.
Many people with Ryan's condition have turned to a unique procedure known as a fecal transplant, which involves taking poop from a healthy donor and inserting it into a patient's colon to recolonize good bacteria into their system.
The population that we're treating this way, this is their last resort. They've been sick for a minimum of 6 months, and this cures them. This classic case that I take care of has an over 90% success rate.
A nonprofit in Massachusetts called Open Biome works with doctors across the country to provide them with screened fecal matter. They're essentially a poop bank.
So we process stool from healthy donors and send it out to hospitals all over the country for use in the medical procedure, fecal microbiota transplantation.
Can you tell us a bit about the process?
We have a three-step process for becoming a donor. Overall, the pass rate is about 4%. So it's about twice as hard to become a donor as it is to get into Harvard. So you go through a 109-point clinical assessment. If you clear that, and most people don't, then you go on and bring in a stool sample. And if you pass that, then you go in and get a blood draw. Because we invest quite a bit of money and time in finding donors, we pay the donors $40 a sample for every poo, and we've got to process it within an hour of passage. Once the material is collected, processed, then it sits in our freezer and quarantined for 60 days. So, you know, they're sort of under medical supervision during the collection process. And then if they pass at the end, then we release the material for use and we'll send it out to clinics.
I think the average is about 150 to 200 grams. The biggest sample we've ever seen is 581 grams, which is just ginormous. Like
what?
That almost completely fills one of these containers.
So I'm just weighed the sample here and grab one of these filter bags. So this is just pumping the liquid through a filter here.
Does some of the donors have a smell that you recognize?
Some donors, I would say, are generally stinkier than others, but I wouldn't say they have a trademark smell per se. So it's no longer in that log form. We broke it all up. I'm just using this pipette. And we're just transferring the liquid into the bottles.
We're ready to freeze these, and that's it. The minimum size is enough to create one treatment, but of course, bigger is always better. We encourage fiber.
We're dealing with life and death issues for patients, and we take that really, really seriously, but we also like to recognize that there's a pretty funny element to what we do as well, and particularly with our donors, get them motivated and engaged. What we've done is we've given kind of an avatar to each donor, and so there's a bunch of poop-related puns, like Albus Dumbledore, or
Ninja Turtle.
Ninja Turtle. Scooby-Doo is a good one. It's nice to have a bit of fun.
How did you find out about donating your feces for science?
They had a flyer up that they were passing around. We were kind of standing around laughing about it, and it was saying, you know, $40 for every poop, and I was thinking, like, man, this sounds great.
How do you collect a poop donation?
There's a little, looks like a Cool Whip container. It sits in the toilet bowl with a little kind of rack. So you pretty much just go like you normally would, as long as your aim is all right. It gets in the bowl, and then you just pop the lid on, that's that. It was really weird at first, especially the first couple samples I turned in. But everyone's so nice without a filter in terms of talking about poop around here that I quickly adjusted to it. So now it's second nature. Especially at the end of every week, they tell you, here's how many people you saved this week. I mean, it was something I was doing every day anyway. Why not help people?
After learning about the success rate of fecal transplants, Ryan is preparing to undergo the procedure.
Did you feel weird about having somebody else's fecal material put into your body?
It was weird at first, but that I don't even think about that at all anymore. Because the way I feel now is weird. I want to feel back to normal. I don't really care what it takes to get that. I just want to feel normal again.
This is done pretty simply with a colonoscopy. So we flush them out, they get an IV, they get sedated. I take a colonoscope, I drive it to the top of their colon, and then we have syringes that are full of replacement poop, and we literally inject 250 cc's or so of poop. That's about a soda can, you know, it's somewhere the volume's about 10 ounces of poop. We go all the way to the top, we inject it inside, we take the camera out.
What's success for you? Like, let's say 100%, 80%?
Yeah, I mean, if I was just not having diarrhea anymore after the surgery and not having pain anymore, that would be, you know, success. And to see a negative test for C. diff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it took us 8 months to treat the first 1,000 patients, and then it took us 4 months to treat the next 1,000 patients. We wouldn't be surprised if, you know, in the next year we're sort of treating, you know, more like, you know, 5 or 10,000 patients a year. Our mission is to change the epidemiology of C. diff and really start to make a dent in the overall national mortality of the disease.
This episode is a part of Seeker Stories. To see all the stories we post here, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.